today I'm making something I've always wanted to do. We're going to take a pork butt, wrap it up in banana leaves, and make some Kalua pork. For this Kalua pork, you only need three ingredients. We got the pig, in this case, Boston butt. We have this Alaea sea salt, which is a salt and red clay mixture. And it's my understanding this particular red clay is only available in Hawaii. Some people call this Hawaiian sea salt. And then the final ingredient are these banana leaves. Okay, so all the flavor, I mean, obviously we're going to get some smoke flavor into this pork, but the primary flavor comes from these banana leaves and the Alaea sea salt. All right, in researching this recipe, a lot of different recipes talk about poking this, putting holes in the pork butt with a fork so that you can work the sea salt, you know, further down into the meat, you know, for more flavor. It seems to me that, you know, a fork is going to put very small holes. So what I'm going to do is just score this guy very lightly. In fact, I can't remember who, but I saw one of the recipes when I was researching this where they scored it as well. But this is going to allow us, if you can see there, see, we'll be able to get the sea salt all down in here another quarter of an inch. I'm not certain I could do that using a fork poking holes. So as soon as I get this guy all scored up, and again, it doesn't have to be perfect, right? We're just trying to get more surface area for the salt. But anyway, as soon as I get it all scored up, we'll be back and get this Hawaiian sea salt on it. All right, I've got 2 tablespoons of the Hawaiian sea salt. I don't know how much it's going to take, to be quite honest with you. If we need more, we'll go get more. And I'm just going to sprinkle it on each side. And by the way, this pork butt is 6.5 pounds, if you're interested. And I'm just going to sprinkle it, as I was saying, on each side. And then rub it down in these cracks. So, you know, not too exciting. And then once I get the whole pork butt salted up, we'll come back. We'll talk about the wood we're going to use, how we're going to get these banana leaves involved. All right, you can see these leaves are kind of long. I've been kind of debating in my mind how I'm going to do this. So what I'm going to do is get the pork on here. It's got all that sea salt. And by the way, the total sea salt I used, Hawaiian sea salt, was 3.5 tablespoons. I think what I'm going to do is wrap this guy go all the way down the leaf this way, and then I'll show you. I'm going to turn a leaf the other way and wrap it around. Okay, these leaves you can really smell. And by the way, these are the I'm no banana expert, but these are definitely the edible kind. I bought these in the grocery. I'm guessing that probably some banana leaves you can't eat, so you want to make sure you get banana leaves. They're okay to eat. Okay, so we've got it wrapped once that way. Now I'm going to get another leaf here. Okay, and you can see, wow, this one's kind of shredded a little bit, but hopefully it'll be okay. All right, then we're going to come back like so. And like so this way. Okay. Let me get this up here where it's a little easier to see and to manage. Okay. And what I'm going to do is just kind of tuck this all up like this. Right? And then I'm going to take some butcher's twine right here, and we're going to tie this guy up. So once I get it, you know, all tied up, I'll show you the final product. And again, we'll get it moved over to the smoker. I'm going to smoke this guy between 250 and 300 today. And I've already got it started, as you can see. And what we're going to do is use some mesquite. I think traditional Kalua pork uses some sort of word that I can't say, but it boils down to being a Hawaiian type of mesquite. I am using the plate setter. If you're using a Weber or a gas grill, you want to set it up for 2-zone heating. Okay. We've got our pork butt all wrapped up here in the banana leaves. I'm just going to close this lid and let it go for about 2 hours.
It's been 2 hours. Now, what we're going to do is take this guy off the smoke. You want to be careful here, right? You don't want to tear up the banana leaves. It's going to take a couple of spatulas, all right? We're going to put it on this foil. And actually, yeah, let's put it just like so. Okay. Now with real Kalua Pork, right, it's down inside a pit that's been dug out and covered up so it steams. So the first 2 hours, we're getting a little bit of that smoke. And now we're going to wrap it quite tightly in this foil, all right, so that we can get the steam action going for those banana leaves, you know, to get that flavor. Now I am going to double wrap this guy. We don't want all those good juices coming out. So I'll just slip her on here like so. Now, let's get our pork back on the smoker. Now, I am going to put a temp probe in this. Put it in the top. I don't think it'll mess it up too bad. And we want to keep this tight. But we want to cook this guy until it gets up to around 200 degrees or so. It's been 5 hours. And our pork butt is up to 203. All right? Ouch. And we're going to get it off the grill. Okay? Now, nobody's home right now. It's a little after 3:30 in the afternoon. So what we're going to do is wrap this guy up. Okay? We can keep it this way 2, 3, even 4 hours. What we're going to do is, in this towel, is just sit it inside this cooler. It'll stay hot for literally hours, all right? But you want to put it in a towel, otherwise you risk damaging your cooler. When everybody gets home, we're going to open this guy up. We're going to make a little Hawaiian rice to go with this Kalua pork. What I've got here is about 2 cups of cooked white rice. Okay? And what I'm going to do is add in just a little bit of this Ponzu sauce. Probably, let's talk about 1 tablespoon. 2 tablespoons. Maybe 1.5 tablespoons. All right? And then I've got cup and a quarter of chopped pineapple. 1/2 teaspoon of diced garlic. About 1.5 tablespoons of chopped cilantro. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about right there. And then 1 chopped up green onion. Okay? Now I've got this burner set on about medium heat. You know, we may need to turn it up. No problem if we do. I just want to brown this rice just a little bit. Get some of the moisture out of it from the pineapple. Good. This is looking so good already. All right, now what I've got here is a little red pepper flakes. I'm probably not even going to use 1/4 teaspoon, not even 1/8 teaspoon. It's optional. If you don't want any spice, don't use it, okay? Trust me, it's going to make it a little bit better. Okay. What we're going to do is just cook this up a little bit, get some of this moisture out, as I mentioned. I've got 1/2 lime here. I'm going to spray the 1/2 lime juice in there. Okay. Now, the last thing we're going to add
It's just a sprinkling of soy sauce. I don't want this too brown. I like the white color. Soy sauce adds some nice flavor. I bet I didn't even put in a half a teaspoon. If you really like soy sauce, then add a little bit more. So, all I'm going to do at this point is just cook this down a little bit. Like I said, the rice is already cooked. We're going to get some of the moisture out of it. Maybe, I don't know, 5-7 minutes. And then we're going to check out this Kalua pork and this Hawaiian rice. Everybody's starting to come home now. Donna's up. She worked all night. My daughter's back. You know, she got this driver's license thing. Now she's wanting to drive everywhere. Is that the way it's supposed to work? You know, I thought they would, like, get the driver's license and want to stay home, right? No, I'm just kidding. Okay. This guy is really hot. In fact, I probably need to remove this towel. You guys can be careful if you're unwrapping this. Let's get this towel out of the way. I don't want to make a ginormous mess on the towel. Okay. Kind of looking forward to seeing this Kalua pork. I've never made this before. I've been wanting to make it for months. It took me forever to find the banana leaves. I finally found them. Where we live, you know, we don't have a lot of whatever you want to call it, ethnic markets and things, so it's kind of hard to get stuff like this. All right. Just bear with me while I get this out of the foil. Oh yeah, look at the color on that. I just want to get it off this foil. You can see I'm moving this everywhere. I'm not so skilled at this right here. Okay, let's get her lifted up. All right, get the foil off. Okay, that's a major milestone. Now, let me get some scissors, and we're going to open this up. Okay, got a knife here. We're going to unwrap this. I don't have a very sharp knife, do I? Holy crap, let me go get a different knife. Okay, let's try this. Yeah, see, got my new, I just got this the other day, just to carry. It's a Swiss Army knife. I like the way it looks. Okay. Anyway, I'm sure you're not too interested in that, but nevertheless. Okay, now we've gotten the strings off. Let's get them out of the way. Look how, I can't believe how much moisture there is here from these banana leaves. Okay, still pretty hot, so you want to be careful. Boy, the leaves, the banana leaves smell awesome. Okay, all right. There's our pork. You're seeing it just like me. First time. It's plenty hot. Let's get this bone out. Okay. Bone comes right out, right off the meat. All right. We're going to try to turn this pork butt upside down so I can get these banana leaves off. Then we're going to pull it and try it. And we'll see how that goes. Oh, not too bad. Okay, let me get these banana leaves out of the way. Then I've got these pulley things. What is that? Oh, that's part of the bone. All right. We're gonna pull this pork. I've never used these before, so I'm learning this too. I can tell you this pork is very, very tender. You can probably see me just ripping it apart. Okay, so let me get this all pulled, and then we'll come back, and we're gonna give it a try. Let's give this Kalua pork a try. The first thing we're gonna do is put a little bit of that Hawaiian rice we made, and then what we're gonna do, just put a little of this pork on the side, right? You could mix the two together, obviously. Okay, look at that. It is so juicy looking. All right, let's give it a try. We're gonna give this pork a try. And then we're gonna follow it up
with some of this Hawaiian rice. Oh my gosh. Well, I can tell you right now, I get why the Hawaiians make this. First of all, if I'm saying it right or saying it wrong, you know, I don't know. The Alaea salt, the salt with the clay from the volcanoes, it does not make this like salty. In fact, you don't hardly even taste the salt. It's in the background. What a wonderful flavor. The banana leaves on this are just, I've never eaten banana leaves, but I can tell you it's got a flavor to it. It's hard to describe. I'm sure it came from those banana leaves. It is so juicy. You get a little bit of smoke. The smoke is not too strong. If you recall, we smoked it for 2 hours with the mesquite. But I'm telling you, this pork is almost like eating candy. It's so sweet, like it melts in your mouth. Of course, the pineapple rice, I mean, it's, you know, it's pineapple rice, right? I mean, it's white rice, pineapple, a little cilantro. It's good. The star of this show is this Kalua pulled pork. Three ingredients, that's all it took. You guys have definitely got to try this. Hey, if you're not a subscriber already, I hope you hit that armadillo pepper icon. If you have any questions or comments about this recipe, just leave them below.